We're starting to see a phenomenon that is, you've seen a lot of the news reports of what we've seen in New York, really 4 to 6 weeks following some of the peak activity in COVID in our communities. And we're seeing children that are coming in with a hyperinflammatory response. So basically, there are several different ways that this is expressing itself. You've heard some of the reports in the media around Kawasaki disease or toxic shock syndrome. But basically, these kids have been exposed to COVID in the recent 4 to 6 weeks period, have kind of convalesced from that, and now are having this post-inflammatory viral response. So many of them are not testing positive through nasal swab, but we're actually finding antibodies in their blood that are consistent with a past exposure to the COVID virus. The symptoms that we're seeing, include fever, many kids with abdominal pain, diarrhea or vomiting, and rash. And, we've seen few here in the Midwest. We're just starting to see it, but we know that there's been a number of cases on the East Coast, and internationally, there's also been a number of cases 4 to 6 weeks following peak volumes in those countries.